Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of Kingdoms. And in today's episode, we are back over here at our little farming village. Still haven't come up with a name for it yet. I had a little bit of a setback between episodes. I fell in lava and died and lost all of my stuff. Luckily for us, we do have the skeleton farm. We did have enough diamonds, and we had a bunch of enchanted books from our AFK fishing farm. So I'm mostly back to where I was. I do have decent boots. I do have a decent sword, although my one that had mending on it is unfortunately gone. And my shovel, unfortunately, does not have silk touch anymore either. And I lost my silk touch picks. So, frustrating, but, you know, it's all part of the game. It's okay. And it could have been a lot worse. Thankfully, we have the skeleton farm, so I was able to get my levels and get a bunch of stuff. And I got a ton of bones, which is great, because we're going to need them in the village here. So, you know, it could have been a lot worse. But I think today, what we're going to do is we're going to start kind of working on some of the farms themselves. Now, this is going to be the farming village, as we had kind of decided. And that means we're gonna need wheat farms, we're gonna need livestock, we're gonna need all sorts of different things, and right now we really don't have any of that. So I think that is gonna be kind of the first thing that I wanna work on. Where's my bed? I think I wanna move this bed. Let's put it right here in the middle just for now. I really need to do something with the interior of this house as well. It's looking pretty bad right now. But we also need to figure out kind of where we're going to put these different farms. And I'm thinking we kind of need to do this in a way that makes sense. So, let me do some planning here. Let me take a nap. Let me get some stuff together. And I'll come back to you in just a little bit. All right, guys. I am back. So, I've been putting some thought into this. And I think what I want to do is I want to kind of map out the farms. And there's a few ways to do farms in Minecraft. You can, I could just convert like giant chunks of land into wheat fields, you know, stuff like that. But I want this to be a little bit more organized than that. So I think we're going to start with some of the, like wheat and vegetables and stuff like that. And what we're going to do is we're going to kind of lay out our farms like this, and actually let's bring that up one more, and this stuff in here is gonna have to go. Goodbye, flowers and things. Sorry, but you're in the way. And we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So that should be 16 blocks in length. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, good. And then we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. So on each side of the farm, we're going to have an area. Oh, once again, grass. Grass in my way. This stuff has all got to go. It's just, yeah. All right, that should be better. We're going to have to carve into this hill a little bit too, I think. Which is fine. There we go. And now the downside is I'm going to use quite a lot of wood for this, I think. So I might have to set up some sort of a tree farm or something here in the near future, but we'll do something like that. And I think that works. That looks good. Okay, now I'm gonna need a bunch of dirt. I'm gonna need a whole bunch of dirt. So let's see, I've got a bunch of grass. I kinda hate to use all my grass. I might peel some of this hill back a bit more, actually. Just kinda looking at it. I don't know that I really want this big hill here. I might wanna just kinda peel a couple layers off this, and then that's actually gonna give me a ton of grass anyway. So let me get that done and I'll come back to you in just a sec. All right guys, I am back. So I've got some of that peeled back a little bit. You really can't tell. I basically just took off the top layer up here, and if I need more dirt, I'll take off this layer too. But let's go ahead and start filling in some of these fields here. And we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, because that's how far water will spread. And these are kind of going to look like the farms that you would find, like in NPC villages, for example. The goal here is not so much function, because let's be honest, there are way better ways to design farms than this, so much as it is form. I want the farms to look good, kind of more than I want them to be functional, honestly. I mean, I want them to be functional too, but I'm honestly a lot more interested in making sure that the farms actually look good. So let's go and grab a couple buckets of water. There we go. I'm also thinking maybe we'll put a well over here at some point in the near future. Just make it a little easier. Don't have to run all the way to the river to get infinite water. And we'll just fill that in like so. There we go. And then I'll take my hoe, and we're gonna hoe this entire thing. All right, so we got that done. Now, I also went ahead and put in some stone walls here so that nothing can get in. None of this should be spawnable, because I'm like 99% sure that mobs cannot spawn on tilled soil. But we will have to get some torches around here to light everything up and all that kind of good stuff as well. And I do want to cap off those logs, just looking at them. So why don't we quick go ahead and make some cobblestone slabs. And we'll just put one of those on top of each of these logs right here. There we go. And there. All right. So now we just need to go ahead and plant some of the crops. So we're going to plant wheat here in a nice row like this. And then we'll do the same on this side like that. There we go. And then I want to get some potatoes and carrots going as quickly as possible. Because the sooner we get these going in large quantities, not only the sooner will we have a good, reliable food source, because potatoes are honestly a great source of food, but the sooner we'll be able to really kind of have another plant that we can grow as well for, you know, kind of decorative purposes. So we'll get our potatoes going here. And there we go. Let's just break all of those guys. That looks good. And let's just go ahead and plant potatoes here. And here. And then I think we're gonna do potatoes again over here. So let's just kind of bone meal all of this as well. There we go. There we go. All right, cool. And we'll break all those up, and that should be enough to plant this whole field with wheat and potatoes. And those two growing together, that should get there. That should get there pretty quick. Now, we do need some coal for torches, because I actually don't have any coal over here whatsoever. There is a cave, like, right over there, which is actually where I died before when I went caving and fell in lava. So I'll have to be careful, but I think what we're going to do is we'll take some of this stuff with us. And then I'll just take a stack of birch. That'll work. I'll use that to make torches and stuff. And we're going to go caving a little bit. We're going to see if we can find ourselves some coal so we can make torches and all that kind of good stuff. So let's see here. I'm sure there's more coal in this cave that I haven't discovered yet, because this is actually a super big cave. Some of it I'd already mined, and some of it I took back to Altum, and some of it I also just kind of lost when I fell in lava. Here we go. Coal. Beautiful. And I do have a Fortune 3 pick, so this will work out just fine. There we go. Let's just get a little bit of that going. That looks good. And let's go ahead and make ourselves a couple of stacks of torches. And you know what? While we're here, I do have a water bucket, right? Yeah, I do. While we're here, why don't we do a little bit of caving? We haven't done any super awesome caving action together for a while, so might as well take a peek. I'm going to get as much of this coal as I possibly can. Let's just put a torch down right there. And this cave does actually extend down to diamond level. So maybe we'll get lucky and we'll find some diamonds. That's what I was looking for when I died in a very unfortunate manner a while ago. Hello, more coal. I can use all of that. There we go. Yeah, now we're getting somewhere. Yeah, here we go. So this cave, as you can see, it goes down pretty far. Let's just put a torch right there. That doesn't seem very spawn safe to me. And I'll take all of this iron. That looks good. We'll put a torch right there. More goodies. Man, we're finding all sorts of good stuff. I do want to get down to diamond level, though, and look around, see if maybe we can find diamonds, because after I died, I had to remake a bunch of diamond stuff, and my supply of diamonds is running a bit low right now. I think I've got maybe like 12 diamonds left or something like that, but that's all that I have, and I need to make sure that I have more because I don't have mending on any of my tools or anything like that. So, you know, when my tools get damaged and are in need of repair, I'm gonna need diamonds to fix them. Let's see, let's just get, man, so much coal. This is awesome. Torch, there we go, that looks good. That is all, that is diamonds. Hello, diamonds. Let's use our super amazing water bucket. And we'll just light all of this up. I'm gonna put a torch there as well. And is that it? Just the one diamond. Just the one. Well, that's a shame. Still. Oh, and we didn't even get a good fortune on it. We just, that's too bad. Let's patch that up too. But we can still look around here a little bit. Maybe we'll get lucky. Ooh, that's a little scary. I don't see anything over there. Let's get our obsidian laid out. Is there any diamonds over here at all? Doesn't seem to be. There's some iron and stuff, though. I'll take it. Does this open up into another cavern? Yes, it does. Good. And I should probably be lighting this up as I go. There we go. I'll take that, too. And, oop, well, there we go. Just take some of this dirt. Why not? That could come in handy. Diamonds over here? Diamonds! I'm looking for you. Ooh, there's some gold. And that seems to be another relatively large cavern over here. Yeah, there's gotta be more diamonds down here somewhere. I don't need a lot, I just want a couple. If I can find like one good vein of diamonds that I can fortune, that'll be good enough for me. I just want to kind of replenish my supply, if you will. I should probably grab this redstone too, actually, because I don't really have a whole lot of it. And the experience could be useful. Hi, zombie. Bye, zombie. Go away. Alright, guys, I'm going to continue caving. I'll let you know if I find anything cool. Alright, guys, I am back, and I'm just working my way out of the cave now. I think I did alright. I didn't find any more diamonds, unfortunately. But I got a pretty good haul. I got like 3 and a quarter stacks of iron, which is great. Getting closer and closer to a beacon all the time. So that's definitely good. I got about half a stack of gold, and I got a whole bunch of coal. So all in all, you know, definitely a worthwhile little caving expedition, I think. Let's see, where's my house? Oh, and I kind of started a path. This is not what the path's going to be. It's not, I don't think the path is actually even going to be path blocks. but I wanted to start kind of laying out where it's going to go, just sort of planning, if you will. And looks like our fields are growing too, so that's definitely good. I think we're going to need a couple more fields, and it's not night, so I can't sleep. That's too bad. Okay, well, let me get some stuff organized, and I'll be right back. All right, so now that we're nice and organized, let's go ahead and see about kind of finishing up this farm. I just want to try a couple things. We're going to make a couple of stairs and a couple of slabs, and I'd like to try putting these down here, because obviously we need a way to get up into these farms, and I don't know if I want to do something like that, or if I want to do the slabs, or maybe we do a combination. Maybe we do something like that. Not that. Think. Then again, with this land being right here, this kind of little patch, we might be better off with a bridge of some sort. But I'm kind of leaning, do I like it better peeled back like that? I think I might. So we'd have some sort of pathway then that would come from here and lead its way around to here. And we'd put a path on either side of that. And I think that's good. And we just need to work out what we still haven't worked out what our actual pathway design is going to be for the village. But these should be mob proof. They should be lit up enough that everything will grow. And they should give us a pretty decent source of different crops. So that's good. Now, I want to go ahead and make another one of these, I think. I don't know that I necessarily want it to be connected to the other one, though. And I'm also kind of thinking that this has got to go. This little pond right here, this little thingy, I think that is in the way and needs to be done away with. So let's just do that. And unfortunately, it's just raining. It's not night, so I can't sleep. It's just raining during the day. Which is always a little bit of an annoyance, but, you know, it is what it is. It's whatever. Hopefully the rain will clear up soon enough, and we'll be able to build without the annoying rain. There we go. Let's just patch that. Now this, I don't know what I want to do with this. I think over here, this is where I'm going to put the carrot farm. And the carrot farm is going to be a lot smaller, I think, than the wheat farms, or than the wheat and potato farms, because it just doesn't need to be that big. It's not really going to see that much use, and now it is getting dark, so can I sleep, please? Yes, thank goodness. I'm so tired of rain. I dislike rain very much. All right, let's grab some of these, and let's grab some cobblestone walls as well. And let's see about laying out a carrot farm here. Now, this one, as I said, it's going to be much smaller. And let's think about where we want to put the entrance to this guy. I'm thinking maybe here. No, maybe here. So it'll be kind of at an angle with this, which I think is probably good. One thing to consider, though, is that these are four. So maybe we only make this one three wide. Maybe we just make this a much... Oh, but if we do that, there's not really going to be a whole lot of space here. Maybe we do... I don't know that I want to double up and do a whole nother big, huge, massive farm, though. But then again, 1, 2, 3, 4. This would be water. 1, 2, 3, 4. I mean, it wouldn't really be that... It wouldn't be the end of the world to do another big farm. I mean, and this is going to be the farming area. So maybe we lay it out, but we just make this one a lot shorter. So instead of being 16 long, we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Like that. That might work. So same kind of a deal, just a much smaller farm. I might like that, actually. I think that's good. I think that's a great idea. And then we still need to peel this hill back a bit, or this little area back here, so that we can actually get to the farm. So let's see, our gate will go here. Okay, that all looks good. And then let's just go ahead and fill this guy in. All right, guys, we've got that done. So now I think we're actually gonna use this field for carrots and beets. I think I'm gonna use it for beets as well, beetroots, which were new in 1.9. And not exactly useful. They're kind of, you can use them to make like beetroot stew or something, which is kind of useless. Also, I should probably mention, I did extend this by one block. So it's nine, essentially it's a 9x9 area, which makes it kind of a square, which I generally don't like doing. I generally don't like having completely square farms, but in this case, I decided to make an exception because then my torches can be nice and evenly spaced along the walls there, which I think is good. So we've got some carrots going. We'll just plant all of those down like that. And over here as well. There we go, got the carrots going. And now we need to plant the beetroots. And those also grow with bone meal. Although it appears they take a bit longer to grow. They require a bit more bone meal than carrots, it looks like. Wow. Those are actually taking a really long time to grow. I've only gotten like 4 seeds, and I'm getting all these beetroots that... You know, the thing with... The beetroots are used to make beetroot stew, right? Beetroot soup, essentially. The problem with soup in Minecraft is you can't stack it high enough that it's actually useful. If they would just change the stack size, I could actually see myself using it from time to time occasionally. But no. They can't do that. You can only... It doesn't stack. It doesn't stack at all, which is super, super annoying. But hey, what do I know, right? All right, let's just finish getting this done, and then we'll take a look at it. All right, guys. So it's all planted. It's all harvested. Well, not harvested, but it's all planted. The farms are up and running, at least the vegetable farms. Let's grab some dirt so we can pillar up and kind of take a look at it from up here. It's getting night already. Man, I feel like it was just day, just a moment ago. And we got a couple of farms here. We got wheat and potatoes. And then over here, we got carrot and beetroots. And it's not bad. It's not too bad. Let's take a look at it from maybe this angle. That looks pretty good. Let's take a little screenshot there. I think it'll do. We need to work out a pathway. And I think I don't want the pathway to cover this whole kind of three wide. I think I want it to be a relatively small, kind of innocuous path that's just kind of there. You know, just very kind of subtle, almost. I also kind of want to split it so that it's not so straight. Because straight paths are boring, if you didn't know that. And then we'll just kind of bring the pathway over and probably up to the door like that. And we'll just kind of plop down Yeah, that'll do. Hi, zombie. Bye, zombie. Leave me alone. I'm trying to build in things. Okay. Can I take a quick sleep? No. Monsters nearby. What other monsters are around? Ah, there's a spider right there that's now dead. Deceased? I think we're good. Let's get rid of that spider as well. Just in case. Now can we sleep? We can sleep. Okay, good. Much better. Okay, now, as far as pathway goes in here, I'm thinking cobble, I'm thinking granite, and I'm thinking diorite, because in this particular texture pack, the three of them are essentially meant for each other. They're meant to blend very well together, and they do. So, I think what we'll do is we'll kind of take the cobble, and we'll kind of bring it along here. Actually, let's grab a little bit of gravel as well. Do I have gravel? I've got a little bit. Not a lot of it. Do I have any gravel hiding in here? No. Do I have moss stone? I do. Okay. So, I think the path is going to be primarily cobble. Like, that's going to be the main block. Like so. Maybe, no, that's too uniform. Maybe we do that. Here it's just gonna kinda come down a little bit. So maybe, now this is gonna be cobble right here. Okay, there we go. And then we'll just take some granite and mix a little bit of that in as well. Like so. And a little bit of diorite. And mix that in as well. And that looks okay. I'm not liking the diorite, to be honest. I think the diorite is a bit too bright for this particular circumstance. So I think anywhere that we had diorite, we're gonna put in gravel instead, and I think that will look significantly better. Also, let's put that back. There we go. So let's try. Yeah, that's much better. That's definitely better. Okay. So you've got this kind of worn down cobblestone pathway road design, which I quite like. I think it works out. We also need a little bit. I need like one stone slab to go right there. Just so you can, you know, get up. And maybe in a couple spots, because I want the dark, the granite. I want that to be a lot less I want that to be used a lot less. I think there's too much of it right now. It needs to be used very sparingly in this path, otherwise it's just too much. And I think, there we go, that's a much better mix. So now, we've got this pathway that kind of connects everything. I think that's a good mix for a pathway design for the farms. I think it works out well. We'll maybe mix some coarse dirt in once we get the ability to do so, once we actually have some coarse dirt. There's a bunch in the Mega Taiga, so I can get it. I just don't have any handy with me, and I could make some with gravel, but eh. I think it's good, though, and I think we are definitely out of time for this episode, guys. So, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. Links in the video description down below, so check that out as well. Other than that, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.